Hey everyone, what do a baseball bat, a grass whip, and an axe have in common with golf? It's all about swing playing today, baby, and many of you are just racking your brains on being on the wrong swing plane. Matt Wolf is a beautiful example of, hey, of how you can be all over the place and still hit incredible golf shots. So this one's a very important video for all of you who are thinking you're defective, but actually you're not. But before we go, you need to subscribe to our channel. You don't want to miss the next video. What else do we need to do?
Give us a thumbs up, leave a comment down below.
Make sure you hit the bell.
All right, see you in a bit. All right, I'm gonna start with the axe. I'm gonna show you guys how you already know this stuff. We work at 40 million bits of information per second. And the last thing a lumberjack needs is to go to a school to show them how to swing an axe on plane, correct? So you'll see, and we have some unbelievable drone views of this particular video that we have right now on premium. You want to check that one out. So if I was going to cut the tree down from very, very close to the tree, I needed to take something out of the tree from down here. Notice how close I am to it. Well, naturally, my swing plane is going to go more upright. If I get a little further away from the tree, for me to catch the tree, I got to swing on a different swing plane now. So notice how I'm heaving the axe on a plane that would have me take the tree. Nice solid cut in the tree. If I'm too low, I miss the tree this way. If I'm too high, I miss the tree that way. So my brain's saying we need the axe to meet the tree. Boom, I'm on the right plane for that. I could go further back and take it more horizontally. So let's say I want to miss the board on top. Well, I'm going to have to heave it in a certain place that would have me miss it from the top. So heave and miss it from the top. And you notice how when the axe went through, it released beautifully in the direction I want that to go. So get yourself, you know, get that axe out of the garden, get yourself right next to a tree, and feel what you need to do to swing that axe on plane. And you'll notice how so natural it will be for you to do so. And that's where, you know, if you look at the length of a wedge versus the length of a 5-iron versus the length of a 3-wood, you'll see that those swing naturally on different planes if you don't think about it, okay? So let's have Savannah come in here for the baseball side of things. Now, if you did play baseball, you would play lefty like me, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say the pitch is coming in very low, you know? There's a little knot right there. Let's go ahead and set up to that knot. That's your bag. So where were we before we were interrupted by your rude golf bag?
Just a low point of the ball coming.
Okay, so you see that little knot right there? You want to, you know, hammer that knot with your baseball bat. Come on in. So notice how instinctive that was.
Yeah.
Now let's say you wanted to hit a high fly ball center field. See that cloud right there? You want to feel like you're going to nick the board on the way up into that cloud. See how natural that is, right?
Yeah.
So while you're stepping into it. So show me a low grounder to first base. Wasn't that a gorgeous over the top move?
Yeah.
Well, that over the top is very necessary if you want to go across your body into first base.
Yeah.
Now, if we're playing golf, we basically want to be going over second base into center field. If you're hitting a draw, it would be left side of second base. So show me left to second base, very high. Very nice. Show me left field. How would you do that? Amazing, right? So there's no thinking involved. There's just the organization of the body in relation to the direction and the height that we want to hit the ball in, right?
Yeah.
Give me that. Again, mm-hmm. Very good. Munashe.
Yeah.
So Mu's going to do a little grass whip in here.
Yeah.
And all I want you to do, Mu, is just cut the grass back and through without stopping right over the hole there that we had in our post in.
All right.
And your goal is just to cut grass. All right. So freeze your backswing. Everybody see that? So right now, you feel like you could cut grass from there, couldn't you?
Yeah.
All right. Now, if I take your backswing and I do that,
yeah.
Any chance of cutting the same place?
No, I'm going to miss the grass.
Probably take my ankles out from there, too.
Yeah, that's right. Right? Yeah.
And?
Here?
Over here. How are you going to cut grass there?
I'm probably going to get into the ground.
Yeah, if you go straight down from there.
Yeah.
Now, Matt Wolf gets to a spot here, but then you watch and he reroutes it coming through on the other side.
Right.
As he's throwing the club toward the target.
Yeah.
But we can get closer to that naturally if we just cut the grass in both directions. Hang on a second. Let me do it with my club next to you.
Okay.
So that's got about the length of a 5-iron, I believe. I got my 5-iron here.
Yeah.
There you go.
Nice.
There's your 5-iron.
Yeah.
There's my 5-iron. So if I swing back and through without stopping next to you, go ahead. We're just going to cut grass in both directions.
Okay.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
So if we're cutting grass in both directions,
yeah.
We are naturally on plane.
Right.
So this is an easy exercise that you can do in your backyard.
Mm-hmm.
If you miss the grass on the way through, well, then you're probably too low.
Right.
And if you dig too much, then you're probably coming in from too high or you're forcing the club down.
Right.
But if we're just cutting grass in both directions, notice when you take that thing,
it
looks a little menacing.
Yeah.
But it's very self-explanatory, isn't it?
Yeah,
you got teeth on both sides.
Right.
There's your grass.
Yeah.
And you're thinking, well, all I got to do is cut grass in both directions.
That's right.
And so do it one more time.
Okay.
Fantastic. So with that club right there, you are perfectly on plane.
Right.
And you'll see how we put that in slow motion for you. You'll see the beautiful positions that we both get into when we're doing that simultaneous cutting of the grass. You're going to really love that.
Yeah.
So I appreciate that, Mu. Thanks, man.
My pleasure.
So if I were to take my three different lengths of clubs right here, Sav, where's that? There it is. So to finish off, I'm not going to whip anybody. It's a lunge whip. It's just to show you if I had a shorter side, it would swing more vertically. If I have a longer side, there's no way this could swing vertically. I would need to stand on something.
Yeah.
So I'm going to take that. I'm going to give it to gravity. And now the G forces are deploying that. And all I got to do is take this to whatever I want to strike with it.
Yeah.
So if you look at my wedge, and this is where you'll also see that the swing plane with each club, if you are trying to keep your hands a fist away from your body with all clubs, well, already you're preventing yourself from getting on the proper plane. If I swing back and through without stopping and cut grass with my pitching wedge, see that? That's how far my hands need to be from the body. I could start here, but as soon as I put it in motion, notice it wants to come back to the same place. I could start here, but then gravity wants to keep deploying it on that spot. So now if I take my 3-wood, notice now it's impossible for me to cut grass in the same spot. And I actually have to give myself even a bit more room. So now when I swing back and through, because I do need to shave grass with that 3-wood, look where my hands are now. With my wedge, they were here. 7 iron or 5 iron are going to be here, and then 3 wood, they're going to be there. So this is definitely going to affect my ability to get on the proper swing plane. So my hands can't be the same distance from the body with all my golf clubs. And so the final aspect that I want to talk about is, you'll see players like Matt Wolf who take the club way outside, and then you'll see other players that used to take the club way inside, guys like Ray Floyd. So if I'm setting up here and I take it way too outside, well, if I want to go towards the target, let's say we take that alignment rod back in here. There we go, I'm going toward those flags. I'm going out there and I want to swing toward the target. Well, when exactly do I come back? Well, your brain knows, okay, right about there, we're off to the target, no problem. But if I wanted to hit the ball, I started there and I want to hit the ball, well, I'm at a perfect position to hit the ball. But if I want to send the ball to the target, well, now I'm going to reroute until I feel like I can send it to the target. That was Fred Couples. That was, John Daly played a lot like that. He turned that into his bread and butter shot. David Duval. And then you look at Matt Wolf, has that same ability to do that. He takes it back with the club way outside the hands. And then as he gets to the top, notice it's across the line. So Matt and I actually get into some very similar positions. I usually take the club sometimes a little too inside, and Sav does the same thing. And then as we get to the top, we get into a similar position, but this is a great spot for me to go to the target with. So notice on this end, everything just drops more to the inside. Now it's on plane heading into impact. So the glue that holds everything together is you delivering your shot out toward the target. So if you're a little too inside or a little too outside, obviously if you get too extreme, then you're making your life a lot more difficult. If you want a nice reset button, you do what Mu and I were just doing before, and we just cut grass. Take any club in the bag and just get into your backyard and feel like you're gonna cut grass in both directions. So notice as I'm cutting grass in both directions, that swing plane looks pretty spot on, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It has nowhere else to go.
Yeah, it's true.
So I stay on, and if I see that the blur of this matches the direction I want the ball to go on, well, we're all set. So you're gonna see a couple of shots here. Mu's gonna hit a couple, Sav's gonna hit a couple, I'm gonna hit a couple. We're gonna use our little Rapsodo unit so that you get a nice trace of that shot. And you know, so I'll hit a little fade and a little draw. So I'm gonna start with my fade. I'm aiming down a little bit left of this alignment rod, which is left of that flag stick over there. And I'm just gonna gather and deliver in the direction I feel like I want to start the ball. So we gather and we deliver that way. And look at that. It's coming right back onto the flag stick. Fantastic. And if I want to hit a draw, play the ball a bit back in my stance, get behind it. Now I'm going to go, you know, feels like I'm going to go across the alignment rod. Gather and start it across that alignment rod. And look at that. Coming. Coming right back on the target as well.
Very nice.
So we're going to have Mu and Sav do a couple of those.
Yeah.
Enjoy, and we'll see you next week. All the best. Yeah.